Okay, good day mga ka-follow. So, thank you for following and liking this YouTube channel of mine. So today, we're gonna discuss about social media marketing strategy for MSMEs, part 1. Okay, so abangan ninyo ang magiging part 2. Napaka-interesting ding ng topic na ito. So, this is to discover the basic principles for strategic and successful social media marketing. Okay, so
numbers are
okay. So what is marketing? Okay, so I believe some of you here may mga idea na kung ano nga ba talaga ang marketing. Okay, so marketing is the activity. Hold on. Marketing is the activity set of institutions and processes for creating, communicating, delivering, and exchanging offerings that have value for customers, clients, partners, and society at large. So, itong marketing na ginagawa ng isang departamento o isang group of people o tayo o kayo mga freelancers din, no? Ito yung isa sa pinaka driving force para sa isang business upang makapag-connect sa mga customers natin. Okay? So, of course, lagi natin titingnan na hindi siya lagi na, or we are not conducting a false marketing. So, it should always have value to our customers or to our target customers so that they would feel na we are true to them, na totoo naman din talaga yung offer natin, na masarap naman talaga yung mga products natin. So, they might as well really patronize our own products. Okay, so that's marketing. Okay, let's move to the next slides. Okay. Hold on. Okay. So, excuse me. What is digital marketing? Okay, so yung marketing natin, ilagyan lang natin ng word na digital. So what is it? Okay? So digital marketing encompasses all marketing efforts. Okay? Almost same principles, almost same strategy from traditional marketing that use an electronic device or the internet. Only it uses electronic device or internet, of course. Kaya nga tinawag ng digital. Although hindi naman talaga totally kinopya yung traditional marketing natin, yung old marketing way natin, but they also based the strategy at yung mga ibang principles dun sa old ways na ginagawa natin. So this is the businesses leverage digital channels such as search engine, social media. So ito yung mga naidagdag, ito yung mga medium, ito yung mga materials na ginagawa for the digital marketing, email and other websites to connect with current and prospective customers. So like before, we have print ads, radio ads. Today, we use of the use of electronic device and the internet, kaya tinawag na digital marketing. Okay. So okay, let me move this just a little bit. Okay, there we go. So, I'd like you all guys, or ka-follow, to understand what is investment versus expense. Kasi this is related with marketing. Okay, so the difference is simple. Investment will start paying you back, and the expense other is a drain on your resources. Kaya ko to in-include, no, sa discussion natin ngayon. Because we see na marketing is a form of expense. Okay, most especially for those startup, we all understand, MSMEs na nag-uumpisa pa lang, they do it their own, or hindi masyadong nag-exert ng effort on marketing. Sometimes they start the business, wala pa nga din talagang karatula, that's very basic. But, to understand us further, ang marketing is a form of investment. Ibig sabihin, you are expecting in return. Okay. Medyo nagulo po ang ating part. Okay, let's continue. So, ano nga ba ang goals and objectives natin when we are doing this digital marketing, specifically on social media? Okay? So, okay. So, hold on. Sinubulo ko slide. Okay. Okay. So, ang goal is a desired result you want to achieve and is typically broad and long term. Okay, so medyo time bounded. So goal is in 5 weeks, in the next 5 years, ano nga ba yung gusto mong mangyari sa business? And as much as possible, dapat meron ka ng roadmap kung ano yung pwede mong or possible na gusto mong mangyari sa iyong business. Okay, so ang objectives defines the specific measurable actions each must take to achieve the overall goal. So, si goal, malaki. It's a broad thing. Okay? So, parang gusto mo, in the next 5 years, meron ka ng 10 branches. So, yun lang. Yun lang muna ang goal mo. So, kung yung 10 branches na yan, ng shop mo or ng business mo, kailangan i-dissect mo siya into objectives kung ano everyday ang gagawin mo, okay? Every year, every week na gagawin mo, no, para ma-achieve mo yung goal mo. Okay. So, here, we have 5 common social media marketing mistakes businesses make. Okay. So, we are now going to go now with social media marketing. But before that, we have to all remember this as a business owner or MSMEs. Okay. So, number one, treat social media marketing as a single discipline. Okay. Move this one. Okay, by the way, I believe all of you here has their own business page. Ito yung requirements natin, no? I believe all of you here are also doing or have an FB account. Okay, automatic and or other social media platform, not only FB. Okay, you have Instagram, TikTok, okay, so understood na yan. So, treat social media marketing as a single discipline. So, parang, okay, focus lang ako muna dito sa isang social media or sa Instagram. Dito lang muna din ako mag-focus. Dito lang muna ako. No? So, depende sa target market mo kung nasaan yung dami ng possible customers or ng leads mo. Okay? So, next. Number two, treat social media marketing as one-way street. Okay. Shouting at their audience. So, parang unang bugso pa lang ng page mo o ng social media mo, parang pinaparamdam mo na agad sa kanila na gusto mo silang bentahan. Okay? Gusto mo silang alukan agad. Okay? So, take it slowly. Okay? Do not shout. Okay? Parang yung sa mga graphics mo, parang andun agad yung mga paramdam na benta-benta agad. Okay? So, number three, jump straight to trying to make a sale. Okay? So, yun nga, in relation to number two, parang gusto mo nang paratingin sa kanila, oh, may binibenta ako, pili kayo, masarap to, okay to. Okay? So, wala pang nurturing na nangyayari. Gusto mo na agad bentahan si customers mo. So, number four, fail to tie social media marketing to overall marketing goals. So, excuse me. So, kaya kayo, diniscuss natin, no, ka-follow, na yung goals and objectives, kung ano yung pagkakaiba. Okay, so, with this, no, pag nag-build ka ng goal mo sa business, automatically, dapat binibuild mo din yung mga marketing strategies mo. So, dapat, dapat, hand in hand, they go together. Okay, yung social media market mo, since you will be doing digital marketing, dapat magkasabay siyang mag-take off. Okay, so, sabi rito, align your efforts with your content marketing and promotions. Okay. Number five, too many businesses start posting and then stop abruptly. Ito ka-follow, no? Ito ang wag na wag ninyong gagawin. Okay? So, ito ang wag na wag ninyong gagawin. Nag-start na kayo ng social media digital marketing ninyo. Sa Instagram, sa Twitter, etc. Blah, blah, blah. For the first 3 months, ang ganda ng pasok. No, ni-nurture niyo yung client, yung possible customers niyo, ganda ng mga graphics, etc. And then after 3 months, stop. Pero continuous pa rin naman yung business niyo. So, it will cause confusion to your possible customers, no? If you will do that. So never do that, ka-follow, no? So kailangan continue siya, no? Kahit na paunti-unti, pero hindi siya titigil. Okay. Now, I will discuss to you para meron din kayong guide on the 22 types of content for social media posting. Okay. So, meron ka na account sa Instagram, meron ka na account sa Twitter, etc. Pero ano nga ba yung ilalagay mo? Ano nga ba yung mga types of content? Actually, this is 100 plus. Pero 22 types lang yung nilagay ko, intendedly for MSME. Ano nga ba yung mga 22 types of content for social media posting? Okay? That is relevant to your business. Okay. Okay, we have here blog post. So, pwede kang gumawa directly ng simple blog directly on your page account or social media mo. Or you can link a certain blog na that they could give value sa yung customers na related sa business mo. You can also have your case studies and testimonials, most especially testimonials, because these are social proofs na yung products mo or yung services mo is excellent. A look behind the scene. So, yung mga products mo, like, pwede siguro mag-video ka kung paano mo siya ginagawa, paano mo siya kinakraft, o paano mo ginagawa, o paano mo posibleng ibigay yung strategy if you're offering a service sa mga customers mo. Very important din dito ka follow kasi makikita nila na ano din, parang ganito pala yan. Ganito pala siya ginagawa. Parang nabibuild yung trust nila sa inyo. Curated content. So, ito yung mga content na nakakuha ka na isang magandang blog post o ng isang article. Curated. So, i-curate mo. Hahati-hatiin mo, no? So, hindi mo pwedeng bibiglain lang din kasi mabobore naman yung audience mo. Okay. For tips, so very important din to, magbibigay ka ng mga tips sa mga followers mo, sa mga customers mo, sa audience mo. Regarding dun sa, like kung services yung in-offer mo, no? Tips on tutorials, on technical, on website development, social media marketing, etc. No? Kung ano man yung in-offer mo. You can also give them quotes, no? That is also related to your business, and explainer video. Okay, there are a lot of explainer video software out there kasi medyo ito, medyo interactive, and this video mas ini-engage ng mga audience or customers ang pag naka-video. Okay, for infographics, pwede rin to, comparison. If you are fond of doing graphics, ito yung isang post lang, pero andun na lahat yung mga information doon sa graphics. Okay, so you have here your holiday greetings, product reviews, very important. Kung ano ba yung perception ng customers mo sa products. Yung demos, very important also. Interviews, mga interview mo if you're offering a service. Para ito, this will build authority. Guides and posters. Okay. Now we have memes. Para naman hindi medyo derecho. Para medyo it will not look like boring naman, no? So pwede kang mag-joke-jokes naman through memes. You can do also polls para malaman mo kung excellent ba yung products mo or yung services mo. You can also do survey, quizzes, para magkaroon ng engagement, para matuwa-tuwa naman sila if they will engage, then it will become a possible leads, no? You can also do contests, no? Masaya sila dito, you promote contests and ang ibibigay mong prize is yung products mo or yung services mo, and video. Okay, sabi ko nga, mas nag-i-engage ang mga audience kapag video yung nakikita nila sa social media. And vlog posts. Okay. Vlog posts, vlog ka lang konti para lang makita na visible ka palagi, na you are a legit business owner. Okay, so that ends my presentation. So please watch out, ka-follow ang part 2 natin. This will be very, very exciting for all MSMEs out there. Thank you, bye!